Let's start with the another topic, anatomy of sunflower. We are going to anatomy of leaf and root in this session. When we talk about the anatomy of sunflower leaf, it is a typically a dicot leaf. Go for this transverse section of the leaf, and one by one we discuss on the various type of the aspects regarding this. You can find here a typical dicot leaf of sunflower. The epidermis of the leaf. Epidermis is nothing but the outermost layer here. This epidermis is normally a dorsiventral, and it has upper and lower epidermis in the dicot leaf. This epidermis is usually made up of a single layer of cells, and these are really closely packed cells. You can find here dumbbell shaped cells are there, and these are does not having any intercellular spaces over there. This cuticle on the upper epidermis is thicker than the lower epidermis. The minute openings found on the epidermis, and these are nothing but the stomatas. So upper and lower epidermis, where the cuticle present, the outermost layer, which is cuticle, known as the cutene, and this cutene is covering on the epidermal cells. So it is a quite larger than the lower epidermis. So here you can find there are the stomatal openings on the upper and lower, both the surfaces of the epidermis. These are called the stomatas. Stomatas, which are normally more in number on the lower epidermis than the upper epidermis. Reason is that it is normally meant for either for gaseous exchange or for the purpose of transpiration. If they are present on the direct upper surface, you can find the more amount of transpiration can be possible because of the incidental rays of the sun directly on the leaf surface. The main function of epidermis is to give rise the protection, and which are the inner tissues called the mesophyll. The cuticle helps to check the transpiration, and stomatas are used for the transpiration and gaseous exchange. Here you can find all these structures. These are the epidermal cells. And this epidermis is covered by the thick cuticle. Now, these are the vascular bundles which are normally at the vein region. But beside that, you can find these are the elongated cells known as the palisade parenchyma. Now, these palisade cells are the chloroplast pigments in that. And these are the vertically arranged cells, and they are normally compactly arranged. It is followed by the mesophyll. Now, all this spongy tissue is known as the mesophyll, and which is full of the spongy parenchyma. When we talk about the vascular bundle, which is centrally placed. So this vascular bundle can be observed in the central region. Now, what about the mesophyll? Now, this mesophyll is nothing but the entire tissue in between lower and upper epidermis. Now, there are two regions basically. One is called the palisade parenchyma, and other one is the spongy parenchyma. Now, this palisade tissue is just beneath the hypodermis, or just on the epidermal, attached to the epidermal cells. So these are vertically arranged cells, and they are compactly arranged, mostly having the chloroplast pigments in that. So these palisade cells are just beneath the epidermis. The palisade parenchyma may contain the chloroplast and have the spongy parenchyma. The function of palisade parenchyma is nothing but the photosynthesis. Now, spongy parenchyma, which is lying below the palisade parenchyma, these are normally irregularly arranged cells and having a loose arrangement of the cells. Spongy cells, which are facilitate normally the exchange of gases with the help of the air spaces present in that. Here you can observe all these air spaces are there, and these air spaces will facilitate the gaseous exchange. Nearest to the stomata and called the respiratory cavity, when it is the, or we can say it is the substomatal cavity. Here you can find these are the stomatal openings, and these openings are nothing but directly opening to the air spaces present between the mesophyll. Here also you can find this is the lower epidermis, this is the stomatal opening, and this is directly opening to the mesophyll tissue. So this indicates that it directly helps in the, we can say, the gaseous exchange. Then what about the vascular tissues? Now, vascular tissue is nothing but the water and mineral conducting tissue, where they are normally present in the veins of the leaf. The vascular bundles are normally conjoint, collateral, and they are closed type of the vascular bundles which are present in that. Here you can observe it is a closed type of the vascular bundle having the bundle sheath. The xylem is present towards the upper epidermis, while the phloem towards the lower epidermis. Now this is the lower epidermis and this one called the upper epidermis, where phloem is present towards the lower epidermis and the xylem elements are present in the upper epidermis. Then vascular bundles are normally surrounded by a compact layer of the parenchymatous cells, and now it is called as a bundle sheath, or we also call it as a border parenchyma. So it closes that particular vascular bundle. This xylem consists of the metaxylem and protoxylem elements in that. Protoxylem elements are normally towards the periphery of that bundle sheath. Metaxylem elements present towards the center of that particular vascular bundle. Normally, it is towards the epidermis, and while the phloem is consist of the sieve tubes and companion cells and the phloem parenchyma in that. Phloem fibers are normally absent in the root of this sunflower stem, and xylem consists of the vessels and xylem parenchyma along with the other cells. The tracheids and xylem fibers are also absent in this particular vascular tissue, particularly in the phloem. Here you can find a complete vascular bundle. This bundle is surrounded by a bundle sheath, which is shown here in particular red color. Now, the upper half is made up of the xylem elements. Here the larger cells indicates the metaxylem elements, and the smaller cells are known as the protoxylem elements. And this is all the xylem parenchyma. Here at the lower side, you can find the phloem elements, and these phloem elements are also packed with the bundle sheath. And here in the center, you can also find the presence of the cells, which are normally we call them as the phloem parenchymatous cells, and which is the xylem elements. So here you can observe all these elements. When we shift to now the root structure of the dicot, we are taking the example of sunflower root and the primary growth in the sunflower root that we are going to study now. When we talk about the complete structure, here you can find the overall arrangement, uttermost layer, which is known as the epiblema layer or the pyliferous layer. It is also called the rhizodermis. This is the outermost layer known as the epiblema, which may have the root hairs. Outermost layer of the root and made compactly arranged cells. They may be the polygonal cells, and they are thin-walled flattened cells which are slightly elongated parenchymatous cells. Epiblema of root differs from the epidermis of the stem is being divided of the distinct cuticle and the stomata. Because this root is nothing but the underground part where you can find there is the absence of stomatas and the thick cuticle. Because cuticle is nothing but the protective layer, instead of that we can find this rhizodermis has been a multi-layered development in the root. The trichoblasts are generally smaller than the epiblema cells. So these are the root hairs, and here you can find the central structure. Now this structure is nothing but the vascular bundle, or in the not vascular bundle but vascular element in the root. Now this particular root section can be divided into three zones. The outermost is the rhizodermis, then cortex, and then the endodermis pericycle. Now this upper epidermis, after it is followed by this zone, is known as the cortex zone. Now here it lies below the epiblema, outermost layer, which is the epiblema layer, and it is just below the cortex can be started. The cortex is made up of many layered thin walled parenchymatous cells. Here you can find these are all parenchymatous cells which are observed here. These are all parenchymatous cells. They enclose intercellular spaces for the diffusion of gases. And the cells of the cortex may store the food inside. So this zone is also known as the storage zone of the particular root. They also conduct the water from the epiblema to the inner tissues. This is xylem tissue, and the phloem tissue is also supplied with the water and mineral. So it also conducted by the epiblema. Then we shift to the endodermis, the third layer. First epiblema, then cortex, and third one is the endodermis. This complete circle is of the endodermis. These are nothing but the young endodermal cells which possess a band of thickening which runs along the radial tangential walls. So this is all the structure. These are the uniform celled structure. The band of this thickening is also called the Casparian strip, and it is made up of the both suberin and lignin. So it is quite identifiable, distinguished layer of the endodermis. These Casparian strips prevent plasmolysis of endodermal cells. Plasmolysis can be stopped or it can be prevented by the these Casparian strips. Due to the presence of Casparian strips, the endodermal cells do not allow walls to wall movement of the substances between cortex and pericycle. Pericycle is the inner layer and this is the cortex. So the pressure can be created from the both sides. So it doesn't allow the movement of substances from cortex to pericycle or from the inner core to the cortical zone. As a result, endodermis functions as a biological check. Biological check post, and all the tissues on the inner side of the endodermis constitute a stelar region. This complete zone is known as the stele, and it consists of the pericycle, vascular bundles, and the central zone is known as the pith. So this is all about the primary structure of the endodermis of sunflower root. Then we shift to the pericycle zone. Now this pericycle is nothing but the endodermis normally is followed by, this is the outermost layer, and this zone is followed by the pericycle layer. This is again a unilayered structure. It may be multilayered in mulberry plant. We can find the multilayered pericycle is there, but normally it is a single layered structure. It is believed that it represents the outer boundary of the vascular strand. जे वेस्क्युलर बंडल किंवा वेस्क्युलर स्ट्रँड जे आपण म्हणतो त्याची आउटर बाउंड्री जी आहे ज्याला आपण रूट मध्ये नॉर्मल याच्यामध्ये बघितलेलं होतं की बंडल शीथ लीफ मध्ये आपण बघितलं वेस्क्युलर बंडलला काय आहे एक बंडल शीथ आहे सो इन्स्टेड ऑफ दॅट इन रूट धिस पर्टिक्युलर वेस्क्युलर एलिमेंट इज प्रोटेक्टेड बाय धिस शीथ नोन एज द पेरिसायकल दिस सेल्स आर नॉर्मली व्हेरी थिन वॉल्ड अँड पेरेन्कायमाटस सेल्स इन द यंग रूट all the lateral roots which originated from the pericycle, and pericycle is absent in the roots of some aquatic plants and parasites. So normally pericycle is present, but only in the aquatic roots we find only endodermis is there and there is no pericycle present. Then what is about the vascular strand present inside? Now from pericycle to inner it is all the vascular strand. It is normally 2 to 6 layer. Alternately, we can find the vascular bundles of the xylem and phloem. These are the xylem elements. Here, number may vary from 2 to 6. Here, you can find 4 vascular strands are there. Here, this is the xylem elements, and these blue colored are the phloem elements. So, these are alternative patches of the phloem. Various xylem bundles may put together to give rise the stellar or star shaped appearance. The number of rays equivalent to the number of xylem bundles in the particular stem. So here we can find the phloem elements are alternately arranged, and these are the metaxylem which are present towards the center and protoxylem at the periphery or towards the pericycle. These protoxylem are first formed xylem which is lying in contact with the pericycle, the younger metaxylem elements we can say. So these protoxylem elements are started from the pericycle zone, pericycle layer, and they just get the mature toward the center. While the metaxylem are the later formed xylem and which is present toward the center of the root. Here also you can find these are the larger cells which are the metaxylem elements, and these are the smaller elements which are the protoxylem elements. Such type of the vascular xylem is called the exarch type of the xylem, and the metaxylem elements of the different xylem bundles may lie separate from one another so that the pith is present in the center and at the center of the root. However, usually these xylem bundles extend along the metaxylem elements radially, and the bundles meet at the center to form a solid star-shaped structure. Here in the roots, the pith is absent. A parenchymatous zone of the in between xylem elements is almost absent in the primary root structure. Now this is all about the primary structure of the root. When we see here, this is all the structure of the primary root. Now, what is the secondary development or the secondary growth? So here that secondary growth in the root of the sunflower starts. The root of gymnosperms and most of the dicotyledons undergo the secondary type of the growth. Now, this secondary growth is found mostly in the dicotyledons root, and because of they forms a thickness similar to the dicotyledons stems. कारण जसं आपण झाड मोठं जेव्हा होतं तेव्हा आपण बघतो की त्याचं स्टेम सुद्धा वाढते, त्याच ॲट द सेम टाइम देर इज द डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ द रूट सिस्टम ऑल्सो, दे बिकम्स ऑल्सो थिकर, अँड बिकॉज ऑफ दॅट सेकंडरी ग्रोथ इज ऑल्सो फाउंड इन द डायकॉटिलेडन स्टेम्स. द सेकंडरी वेस्क्युलर टिश्यूज ओरिजिनेटेड ऍज अ रिझल्ट ऑफ कॅम्बियल ऍक्टिव्हिटी. नाउ धिस कॅम्बियम इज टिपिकली फाउंड इन द डायकॉटिलेडन रूट अँड स्टेम्स, इट इज नॉट फाउंड इन द monocotyledonous stem. The phellogen gives rise to the periderm. So here you can find the primary and secondary. This is the diagrammatic sketch for that. In primary structure, we find there is the primary xylem, outer there is the primary cambium is there, and these are the phloem patches we just have seen here. These are the phloem patches. These are the xylem elements, and it is encircled with the cambial tissue. Now this cambium, outermost layer of these parenchymatous zone, here you can find there is a development has been started in the secondary xylem elements. Here you can find all these structures where you can find this is the primary xylem and this is the cambial layer. So this cambial layer, this has been increased here, they have been spreaded, and the phloem patches are shifted towards the periphery, and thus there is the formation or development of the secondary growth has been started in the root of this particular sunflower. What are the changes are being taken place during this structure? Here you can find a typical cell primary growth where we can say how this cambium has been formed. You can just look at here, this there is nothing but the cambial cells. Now here you can find the dicotyledonous root possesses the limited number of radial vascular bundles with the exarch xylem. Number of the bundles or vascular bundles is fixed now here. They are normally, the pith is very little or almost absent. This pith, later on we can find it is all filled with the xylem elements. So pith is almost absent in the dicotyledonous roots. On the initiation of secondary growth, we find a few parenchymatous cells beneath the group of phloem becomes the meristematic, and thus many cambial strips are formed as a number of phloem groups. आता इथं आपण बघितलेलं होतं, here there is the restricted number of the phloem cells. Phloem patches are restricted. आता याच्यामध्ये काय झालेलं आहे, here there is the growth of these cells has been taken place and started. Now here you can find secondary growth has been initiated, that few parenchymatous cells beneath the each group of the phloem becomes meristematic. जेव्हा एखादी सेल मेरिस्टेमॅटिक सेल मध्ये कन्वर्ट होते, नाऊ इट कॅन हॅव कॅपॅसिटी टू ग्रो इन टू एनी सेल, आणि म्हणून मेरिस्टेमॅटिक डिव्हायडिंग सेल्स तिथे तयार झाल्या, तर त्या पद्धतीने ह्या कॅस्पेरियन स्ट्रिप्स तिथे तयार होतात, अँड दस द नंबर ऑफ मल्टिपल ग्रुप्स ऑफ द फ्लोएम इज बीन स्टार्टेड. दीज कॅम्बियल सेल्स डिव्हाइड टँजेन्शियली अगेन अँड अगेन. म्हणजे आता रेडियल डिव्हिजन म्हणजे टुवर्ड्स द पेरिफरी, अँड टँजेन्शियल मीन्स टू राईट अँगल टू रेडियल डिव्हिजन्स. तर असे टँजेन्शियल डिव्हिजन्स त्याचे तिथे सुरू होतात, अँड इट इज द मल्टिपल वेज अँड फॉर्म्स द सेकंडरी टिश्यू. द फर्स्ट फॉर्म कॅम्बियम नाउ एक्सटेंड टुवर्ड्स द बोथ ऑफ इट्स एजेस अँड रिचेस इन द इनर मोस्ट डेरिव्हेटिव्ह ऑफ द पेरिसायकल, दस गिव्हिंग राइज टू अ कम्प्लीट रिंग ऑफ कॅम्बियम. आता कॅम्बियमची पूर्ण रिंग जर आपल्याला तयार करायची असेल, तर इथं काय व्हायला पाहिजे, कंटिन्युअस डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ द फ्लोएम पॅचेस हे तिथं व्हायला पाहिजे. आणि कारण फ्लोएम जो टिश्यू आहे, फ्लोएमच्याच काही सेल्स मॉडिफाय होतात आणि त्या मेरिस्टेमॅटिक मध्ये कन्वर्ट होतात, सो दे गिव्ज राइज टू अ कॅम्बियम सेल्स. द हा फ्लोएम पॅच इथं आहे इंटरनल टू द फ्लोएम, अँड दीज आर द झायलेम एलिमेंट एक्सटर्नल टू द फ्लोएम. तर अशा पद्धतीने त्याची ग्रोथ ही इथं आपल्याला होताना दिसते. द कॅम्बियल सेल्स प्रोड्यूस मोर झायलेम एलिमेंट्स दॅन द फ्लोएम. द फर्स्ट फॉर्म कॅम्बियम प्रोड्युसेस द सेकंडरी झायलेम मच अर्लियर, अँड हेवी कॅम्बियम रिंग्स अल्टिमेटली बिकम्स द सर्क्युलर वन. द होल कॅम्बियम रिंग बिकम्स द ऍक्टिव्हली मेरिस्टेमॅटिक. आता जेव्हा पूर्ण कॅम्बियल रिंग इथं तयार झालेली आहे, the complete ring starts the actively dividing. Now the complete ring of cambium becomes the active here, and it behaves like a similar way in the stem. Stem madhe ja paddhatine tyacha modification hota, tyach paddhatine ti cambium itha act karna suru karte. It gives rise to the secondary xylem on its inner side and the secondary phloem towards the outer side. तर इथं आता काय तयार झालेला आहे, त्याच्या आतल्या बाजूला तो झायलेम देणार आहे आणि त्याच्या बाहेरच्या बाजूला सेकंडरी फ्लोएम देणार आहे. सो इनर साइड देर इज द सेकंडरी फ्लोएम डेव्हलपमेंट स्टार्ट्स, अँड द आउटर साइड देर इज द सेकंडरी फ्लोएम डेव्हलपमेंट स्टार्ट्स. देन पेरिडर्म हॅज बीन डेव्हलप्ड हिअर. सायमल्टेनियसली द पेरिडर्म डेव्हलप्स इन द आउटर रिजन ऑफ द रूट. द सिंगल लेअर्ड पेरिसायकल बिकम्स द मेरिस्टेमॅटिक, आणि इट डिव्हाइड्स गिविंग राईज टू अ कॉर्क कॅम्बियम ऑर द फेलोजन. आता कॉर्क कॅम्बियम आणि फेलोजन हा टिश्यू आपल्याला आधी आपल्याला प्रायमरी स्ट्रक्चर मध्ये तो नाहीये, बट हिअर इन द सेकंडरी स्ट्रक्चर वी फाइंड दॅट देर इज द डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ सेकंडरी स्ट्रक्चर हॅज बीन स्टार्टेड. इट प्रोड्युसेस अ फ्यू ब्राउनिश लेअर्स विच आर नोन एज द कॉर्क सेल्स. आता कॉर्क कॅम्बियम किंवा कॉर्क सेल्स ह्या कुठे डेव्हलप होतात, नॉर्मली दे आर डेव्हलप इन द स्टेम. द फेलोडर्म डज नॉट कंटेन एनी क्लोरोप्लास्ट. आता रूट आहे, सेकंडरी स्ट्रक्चर आहे, रूट अंडरग्राउंड असतो, त्याच्यामुळे नॅचरली त्याच्यामध्ये क्लोरोप्लास्ट हे त्याच्यामध्ये असणार नाही. हिअर यू कॅन ऑब्झर्व द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस सेल एपिडर्मिस, हाऊ इट हॅज बीन मॉडिफाईज फ्रॉम द प्रायमरी टू द सेकंडरी स्ट्रक्चर. दिस इज द प्रायमरी स्ट्रक्चर where we can find primary structure, metaxylem elements, protoxylem elements, and alternative with the phloem patches. Now these phloem patches are now here converted and the cambium ring has been formed. Yachyamadhye modification kashat zalela hai, phloem cells, these phloem cells are primary phloem cells now developing into a secondary phloem patches development has been started here with the कॅम्बियल रिंग. कारण याच्यामध्ये फ्लोएम पॅचेसच मेरिस्टेमॅटिक सेलमध्ये कन्वर्ट झाल्या, त्याच्यानंतर त्याचा कॅम्बियम तयार झाला, आणि कॅम्बियम तयार झाल्यानंतर ते कॅम्बियम कंटिन्युअस झाल्यानंतर त्याची ऍक्टिव्हिटी इथे सुरू झाली. मग कॅम्बियमची ऍक्टिव्हिटी जेव्हा सुरू झालेली आहे तेव्हा त्यानं काय तयार केलंय, सेंट्रली जो झायलेम एलिमेंट आहे तर आतल्या बाजूला त्यानं झायलेम डेव्हलप तयार करणं सुरू केलंय, त्याला आपण सेकंडरी झायलेम म्हटलेलं आहे. सेकंडरी झायलेम मेड्युलरी रेज आर फॉर्म इन साइड आणि आउटर साइड ऑफ द कॅम्बियम यू कॅन फाइंड द सेकंडरी फ्लोएम हॅज बीन डेव्हलप्ड. आणि हा सेकंडरी फ्लोएम इथं तयार झालेला आहे, तो पॅचेसमध्ये तयार झालेला आहे. आणि तो सेकंडरी फ्लोएम तयार झाल्यानंतर त्याच्यानंतरची ती थर्ड स्टेज जी आहे ती आहे डेव्हलपमेंट ऑफ द पेरीडर्म. तर पेरीडर्म मध्ये आपण इथं बघितलं की जी आउटर मोस्ट लेअर आहे कॅम्बियमच्या बाहेरची, तर त्याच्यामध्ये आता आपण इथे बघतो कॉर्टेक्स झोन नंतर दिस कॉर्क टिश्यू हॅज बीन स्टार्टेड डेव्हलपिंग. डर्म प्रोटेक्ट द रूट वाइल द ग्रो.